This project is all about trying to understand the archaeology of a very important royal centre that was located in Lyminge in the Anglo-Saxon period. And we're doing that through open area excavation on a large scale within the core of the village. The key discovery is that of a previously unattested royal complex that lies literally inches below the surface of Tayne Field. This is the first example of one of these sites that we've excavated systematically within the Anglo-Saxon Kingdom of Kent. This is the very first time that we've been able to put the archaeology of a known Anglo-Saxon monastic community in its longer-term context, to see how it impacted a pre-existing royal centre and transformed the lives of the people that lived here. We're standing on the site of Canon Jenkins' investigations. He was the vicar of the church in the 1850s. He was very knowledgeable of the historical origins of a monastic community here at Lyminge, and that led him to try and recover the church, or the core building, at the heart of the monastic community. And literally inches below our feet, we have the foundations for a 7th century church that he revealed back in the Victorian period. So this wall here with the gravestones in it is actually constructed around the eastern apse. Now everything's been backfilled and you can't see anything at all. This year has produced the largest of a whole suite of major timber halls that formed our 7th century royal complex. It's on a massive scale, over 10 metres wide, 20 metres long, with really major structural elements to it. We've also found some really fascinating, slightly earlier Anglo-Saxon archaeology that appears to be focused on a prehistoric monument, a Bronze Age barrow. We have further buildings dating to the 6th century and this remarkable midden deposit that's filling a hollow that's produced a wealth of 6th century artefacts.
So what we're looking at here is a really large area of rubbish, essentially. It's a rubbish tip, or a midden, we could call it in archaeological terms. Within this midden area, we're getting quite a lot of really interesting objects which may relate to activity on the site, and perhaps will help explain why we have this sunken area at all, because these areas are very unusual. But we've got some really interesting clues. For example, this sort of thing, which looks incredibly unattractive, it's not a pretty artifact, a brooch or a piece of glass or anything. It's actually a piece of a smelting slag. So they've been smelting iron and it's attached to this orange clay. This has been fired, so it's been very, very hot. So we're actually looking at the hearth or the furnace that which would have been part of the smelting process here. So perhaps some kind of metalworking going on in this site.
Right, so in front of me, I've got a selection of the many fragments of vessel glass that have been produced by the excavations this year. One of the commonest vessel types that we've got are what's known as cone beakers. We've actually got the entire base of one of these cone beakers from our excavations this season. Vessels such as these cone beakers have been found previously in Anglo-Saxon graves, cemeteries of this period, and very occasionally they come up whole. This is a modern replica of one of these cone beakers, but what we're finding are the smashed remains of these vessels that are broken in daily use. But what it's telling us uniquely is the wide range of vessels that were being used as part of feasting events here at our high status settlement complex at Lyminge in the 5th and 6th centuries. Arts and Humanities Research Council funding has allowed us to excavate on a large scale, a scale necessary to uncover what is very delicate archaeology. So, for example, we employ professional archaeologists from the local commercial unit, the Canterbury Archaeological Trust. We have two members of their field staff that work with us throughout the excavation season. We also employ their education officer to help with the local outreach that we do to local schools. We are also partnering with a major voluntary organisation in Kent, the Kent Archaeological Society. We use some of their facilities. For example, our travelling exhibition is currently in their museum in Maidstone. We wouldn't have been able to do any of that without the funding provided by the Arts and Humanities Research Council. There's various ways that we engage with the local community. One of the most important is that we hold inductions twice weekly for anybody and everybody, basically. So without any previous archaeological experience, as long as people attend that 2-hour induction, they can then participate directly in the excavations themselves and help us dig this really important Anglo-Saxon archaeology. The other way is that we involve members of the local community in artifact processing. And a core team has been with us on a daily basis and made a massive contribution to what is a really essential part of the process of excavation. We also hold a major open day once during the season towards the latter stages with lots of activities for children. We also have Anglo-Saxon reenactors doing crafts, for example, to help bring the archaeology to life. I do 4 site tours over the day, and it's proved hugely successful. We had about 500 visitors last year, and we're hoping to get the same this season. But it's also very much about training the next generation of archaeologists. We have several students from the universities of Reading and Kent, but also other UK archaeology departments, for example, UCL and York. We're actually training up archaeologists, the next generation, on this really important Anglo-Saxon archaeology.